So the first part of our journey from logistic regression to multilayer neural networks is to modify the logistic regression model so that it can deal with multiple classes. So here in part one, we are going to introduce the so-called Softmax regression model. So Softmax regression is just another name for multi-class logistic regression, and sometimes also called multinomial logistic regression. Previously, in the last unit, we talked about logistic regression for binary classification. That means two classes. So previously, we had the sigmoid activation function, 0-1 class labels, the binary class labels, and the so-called binary cross-entropy loss function that we used to train the logistic regression model. Now we are going to upgrade our logistic regression model so that it can deal with more than two classes. For that, we are swapping out the sigmoid activation function with a so-called softmax activation function. So now, instead of having 0 and 1 class labels, we deal with problems where we have more than two classes. So for example, it could be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So for that, we are going to learn about a concept called one-hot encoding. So we are going to one-hot encode our labels. And then lastly, we will also learn about how we can upgrade our binary cross-entropy function into the regular multi-class cross-entropy function, which can then deal with multiple classes. So before we dive into the nitty-gritty details, let's just recap the general structure of single-layer neural networks. So here we have the schematic where we have the inputs on the left-hand side and the bias unit. And then we compute the weighted sum here, we call it Z, which then is passed to the activation function, which then returns the activation A, and from the activation, we then obtain class label O. So here we see the structure of the logistic regression model that we covered in unit 3, including the threshold unit that follows the activation. Now we are going from binary logistic regression to multi-class logistic regression. Multi-class logistic regression is also called softmax regression. The first step is that we need multiple weights. So we are taking the structure from above, and we are duplicating the structure here. So here in this case, we have three sets of weights, and this would be then a model for three classes. And next, we are swapping out the sigmoid activation function and replace it by a softmax activation function. Don't worry yet how the softmax activation works. We will cover the details later on. Then another small modification is that we get rid of the threshold function and replace it by a so-called argmax function. Again, this is something we will cover in more detail later. And as I mentioned earlier, this would be a logistic regression model that can deal with three classes, 0, 1, and 2. Some people refer to this also as logistic regression, which is correct. But to distinguish between binary logistic regression and the multi-class logistic regression, we will refer to multi-class logistic regression as softmax regression. So softmax regression is very similar to the logistic regression model that we covered earlier, except now that we have multiple sets of weights. We have the softmax activation instead of the sigmoid activation. And we have this argmax instead of the threshold. You can also see that I already added a detail here that the softmax activation function also returns values between 0 and 1, just like the sigmoid activation function. But that's just one little twist, which we will cover later on. But before we get into the part where we compute the probability values, let's focus in on these sets of weights here on the left-hand side. So let's start with the left-hand side where we compute the dot product plus bias unit, our weighted sum. So this is identical to what we covered in unit 3. And here in the code example, x refers to one training example. And as you can see, there are two values, and these are the two feature values. So corresponding to the two feature values, we have then two weight units in the vector w. And then there's of course one bias unit. Now to change this from the simple binary logistic regression case to the multi-class logistic regression model, we have to add more weights and more bias units. So on the left-hand side, suppose we have a model for three class labels, 0, 1, and 2. In general, this works for an arbitrary number of class labels. But just so that we can fit it on this slide here, assume we have only three classes. And since we then have three classes, we need three sets of weights. So the first row of W now refers to the first class, which is class label 0. Then the second row refers to class label 1. And the third row refers to class label 2. And correspondingly, instead of having a single bias unit, we have now a bias vector consisting of three values. The way we compute the dot product, the weighted sum, is still the same though. except that W now is a weight matrix. And we add this little transpose here to make the matrix multiplication work. So what code changes are actually required when we take our logistic regression class and modify it to softmax regression? So here for reference, we have the logistic regression class that we implemented in unit 3. And here now we have the new softmax regression class, which can deal with multiple class labels. And if you pay attention, you probably notice that this slide looks almost identical to the previous slide. So what has actually changed from logistic regression to softmax regression here? Well, the first thing we changed here was, of course, the name of the class. So instead of logistic regression, we just use the name softmax regression now. The second change is that we adjusted the number of outputs in the linear class from 1 to 3, assuming that we are working with a problem that has 3 distinct class labels now. And yeah, of course, if we had 5 labels, we would change that number to 5. And it's maybe best practice to change this into a variable that we can then define when we instantiate a new object from this class. And we will do exactly that in the coding exercises later on. And then the last change we had to make is just to swap out the sigmoid activation function with a softmax activation function here at the bottom. Okay, so in this video, we learned how to modify logistic regression by adding multiple weights and multiple bias units so that it can deal with multiple classes. However, we haven't talked about how we actually get the class labels yet. So in the next videos, we will learn how to convert the softmax activation scores into class labels.